rounding. Well, before we really talk about rounding, let's talk number places. All right. Anything to the left of the decimal is considered a whole number. Anything to the right is considered fractional. If we say round to the nearest tenth, we're talking one decimal place. To the nearest two places, we're talking rounding to the nearest hundredth. Three places, we're rounding to the nearest thousandth. We can keep going, but this suffice. If we say round to the nearest unit, we're talking right here. Some have maybe heard this referred to as rounding to the nearest whole, meaning no fractional part. Now when we round, if I was to say round to the nearest unit, we look at the unit spot, but we look at the number to the right of it. If the number to the right of it is 5 or larger, this rounds up. So if we was rounding to the nearest unit, the answer would be 43.57. If the number to the right is less than 5, then the number doesn't change. So in this case, if I said round to the nearest tenth, we look at the tenth, we look at the number behind it. The number behind it is a 3. It's less than 5, so our answer would be 43.56.9. All right. Now, where does rounding come into play? Rounding is great for estimating, because a lot of times math can be done on a quick estimate. (43.7 × 18.6). Well, I can give you the approximate answer quickly by rounding 43.7 to 40, because 3 is less than 5, and 18.6 is almost 20. 40 times 20 is the same as saying 4 times 8, 4 times 2, which is 8, with the two zeros. So 40 times 20 would be 800, which gives you an approximation of 43.7 × 18.6. All right? Rounding.